5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Everybody, and welcome to this LCTV Sports broadcast of Littleton High School football, and happy Thanksgiving. We are broadcasting from the Harold G. Norton Athletic Complex in Ayer, Massachusetts, where the Littleton Tigers, who are 3-7, take on the Ayer Shirley Panthers at 6-3. My name is Mark Crory. I'm with John Kazanjian. How are you doing, John?
Good. Happy Thanksgiving to you, Mark, and Judy upstairs on the camera. And beautiful Thanksgiving day, turkey, apple pie, and football, right? Is that what you think of in family on Thanksgiving? So here we are for one of those beautiful things about Thanksgiving Day.
Absolutely. And this is the first time we broadcast from the new booth here in Ayer. They have got a new field, they've got a new booth, new bleachers. It's beautiful, absolutely beautiful. And we're nice and warm and toasty while Judy is freezing up there on top.
Sorry, Judy.
Yeah, but that's okay. So it should be an interesting game today, John. You know, Littleton has won two games in a row in those little in-between weeks. They didn't make the playoffs, but they've able to pick up two wins in the preceding weeks, which has been great. On the other side, Ayer made it to the playoffs. They lost the first round. A close one. In fact, all their losses have been pretty close. They've only, last week was their biggest loss, or the last game against Tingsboro, where they lost by 8 points. So that's only a touchdown and an extra point, 2-point conversion. So all their games have been close. They're a tough team. They're a good team. It's going to be a tough matchup for Littleton today.
Yeah, you know, Littleton is coming into this knowing that they have a lot to overcome to win. You know, they have Cam Marshall over there for Ayer Shirley is their stud player. So all eyes will be on him. He is number 8. And, you know, Littleton's coming in. This is the last, you know, starting all the lasts for the seniors. Last game for football, last day of football. Seniors for the cheerleaders as well. This is it. This is the last time that they get to suit up and go out there and show their Littleton pride. And, you know, I'm expecting them to have a lot of fight in them today. They played a great game last week or a week and a half ago over in Blackstone.
Millville.
Blackstone Millville was a great game. 4th and 1 at the 15-yard line. Littleton made a big, huge tackle. Zach Milner stopped them, their defensive MVP, and he saved the game on a 27-24 win against a very good, very evenly matched game. Went back and forth, very exciting. So
that's great. And the of course, the Tigers had their annual banquet, I guess, recently. And why don't you tell me who was some
of the... Yeah, it was last Thursday night. Coach Easter held his first banquet for the team alongside Lynette Sinquist, who was in her last year being the coach of the Littleton High School cheerleaders. So we all thank her for her years of you know, dedication to that program. But, you know, the MVP of the season was, you know, no surprise, number 1, Brian Maurice, who... had, you know, 800 or 900 yards rushing and, you know, kind of played, not kind of, he did play on both sides of the ball very strongly. You know, he's their offensive powerhouse player.
Well deserved. Congratulations.
Yeah, our unsung hero this year went to Jenna Kivlin, a very good honor for her as an offensive lineman starting here for Littleton High School this year. An amazing, talented player who... you know, overcome some obstacles to start on that offensive line. We also had the lineman of the year was Thomas Kazanjian, my baby boy, so I'm really proud of that.
Congratulations.
We had some mid-watch all-stars as well on the team, got named that night. Number one, Brian Maurice. We had number 10, Zach Milner. And number 59, Thomas Kazanjian, got mid-watch all-star. So a very cool honor for my son and those other two gentlemen as well.
All right. Well, we're about to have the air team. If you pan over to the left a little bit, Judy, you can see in the corner of the left end zone, they're about to enter the field, and then we'll have the high school band under the direction of Michael Powderly. We'll do the national anthem. But
familiar name. Richie Powderly, a captain from last year's team. I don't imagine any relation, but...
Could be. Well, I did talk to the athletic director this week about air season, and just he mentioned that they were very disappointed with the obviously the first round exit from the playoffs, and it was a close game too, and I think they lost by 2 points or something like that. But they didn't really have their heart in it against Hingsborough, and so that's kind of why they lost by 8. But I expect their heart's going to be there today as they get ready to.
Yeah, last day, Thanksgiving Day tradition. Again, same thing on their side of the ball. It's their last game of the year, last time to suit up. So a lot of pride on the line for both teams here as they line up against each other. Littleton's had their way with Air Shirley over the last, number of years. So it's time to turn the table. It seems like today, I think.
Maybe.
We'll have a battle on our hands, though. Littleton's ready to fight, and they're mostly healthy. Everybody's back. Alex DeLorenzo's back on the defensive side of the ball. He had that broken finger or wrist.
And Brady DeCost is back, too, but I'm not sure if I'm
Yeah, I believe Greg DeShane will start at quarterback, from what I understand. You never know until they come out there, but Brady DeCosta is back from his high ankle sprain. He suffered in the last home game that we had.
Well, it's good that he's back on the field for senior year, last game. I do recall a little trivia for you, Littleton trivia. You like that?
Sure.
Okay. 40 years ago today, I played in my last Littleton High School Thanksgiving Day.
What number were you?
22.
22.
Number 22. And
nice.
We lost by 2 points to Neshoba Regional. It was a home game, and it was much like today, very cold, little colder, actually. It was a tough game. It's really tough when you lose Thanksgiving. I can tell you that the turkey doesn't taste as good.
Was but that a home or away game?
That was a home game, and that's made it doubly hard, but...
Nice. Well, that's it is trivia. I would have not known that. Number 22. Gotcha.
Yep. I played defensive end and an offensive end. That was my positions. I also did the punting. And we finished with a 3-7 record as well. So I can sympathize with this year's Tigers because it's
everything's
tough.
Coming full circle, I suppose.
It's like a bad flashback.
40-year cycle.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, those two wins last 2 weeks really put a bright spot on this season. That was really tough for the Littleton team to handle, but they had two great games back to back and two wins to make the season back to a respectable one.
Yeah. Now the Air High School Marching Band is coming in on the field on the left. Like I said, they'll be leading us the national anthem probably after the coin toss. But, John, this is the first team that I've seen or a school that has a marching band still. You see some pep bands and things out in the bleachers, including Littleton. But this Air actually has a marching band. And
yeah, that's, a fun tradition that's you don't see very often in the Northeast these days. But, the Littleton band suits up in their own gear.
Yeah.
But these guys have uniforms and everything, so that's pretty cool.
It's the good thing about Air this year, as I look in their team on the sidelines, they're not a big squad. So the fact that they did so well with small numbers like this is probably a testament to, the grit and determination that they have this year.
Yeah, very good season by an under-man group, small number of players. We're getting ready to do the coin toss here. We have.
It's interesting. They only have the three captains out there for Littleton. They didn't bring a fourth. Usually they pick someone to come out, but maybe because it wasn't a game.
Yeah, last game they had Jenna Kivlin as the honorary captain. So, but you know, Brian Reese, number one, number 59, Thomas Kazanjian, number 55, Evan Montgomery as the captains on the coin toss. And for Air Shirley, we have number 8, Cam Marshall, who we mentioned earlier. He's their stud player. And number 1, Brian Holmes, the quarterback. And I'm not sure who the other gentleman is there in the jacket.
Looks like Ryan Marchand.
Ryan Marchand must be injured, number 10, but he's not dressed today, not suited up.
So Littleton is going, has declined. And they defer to the second half.
So they will defer. Littleton will get the ball in the second half. They will kick off. The traditional banging of the bodies and pump up portion here before the national anthem.
So we'll pause here for the national anthem, and then we'll be back with the opening kickoff.
Our flag is located to the right of the scoreboard. We ask all veterans and first responders to please stand and be recognized. Thank you for your service to this great nation. Now we ask everyone to please stand, remove your caps, and welcome the Air Shirley Marching Band under the direction of Mr. Michael Parloli, Director of Music at Air Shirley Regional High School, and drum major Senior Maria Marinas and Junior Teddy McDonald as they play the national anthem.
So the national anthem is played, and here we are, Thanksgiving morning, John. We get ready for the opening kickoff. Littleton will kick off to Air, and we'll see what happens.
Yeah, you know, obviously that first drive sets the tone. See if Littleton can step up to the challenge. They've come alive on the run defense the last 2 weeks. Let's see if they can continue that against a team that is very good at running the ball. You got the captains back there, number 1 and number 8, Brian Holmes and Cam Marshall to receive. TB12, Tyler Branco will kick off. Tyler had a beautiful touchdown pass in the JV game against Air Shirley on Monday. Hit Nick Brooks in the corner of the end zone. It was an absolute laser. So, you know, we're not sure who the quarterback will be next year. Tyler Branco sort of stepped up to be that person this year, not what he expected. You know, he came into the team, never played before, so, but maybe he'll be your quarterback next season.
Well, he seems like a good athlete, so.
Tyler Branco,
yeah. All right, here's the kick. Go ahead, Mark.
Thanksgiving Day game is underway. It's kind of a squib.
Trying to keep the ball away from number 1.
Still rolling. Picked up by number 1. He looks for an opening. Cuts back.
And number five, Mark Fazoli with a fumble.
The ball is hard, and Littleton has it.
Littleton recovers at the 47-yard line. Big fumble. Can't see who came up with that ball.
Wow, that's just the thing that Littleton needed, I think, to get things rolling here.
I did not see who recovered that fumble, did you?
I did not. There was about three or four Littleton guys on that ball that came out. So it was about a 20-yard return for the number one, Brian Holmes. And then he just, you know, it is cold out here. The ball is cold. It's slippery. So Littleton, first and 10 on the 47. Handoff is to Maurice. Oh, nice pickup. Oh, there's a flag on the play. We'll see what the man in the white hat has to say.
No, it's a holding on Littleton.
Oh, that's too bad. Well, I wondered why they picked up 8 yards on the first down. So,
yeah, they love that first play to Brian Maurice, that little read option play. You know, we do have Gregory Shane starting at quarterback. We weren't sure exactly. So number 13 is in there to start. Imagine we'll see both quarterbacks today being their last game as seniors. But, you know, nice little run wiped out by a holding call.
Well, the good news is that it was from the mark of the hold. So
first and 12 now.
Yeah.
All right, so we got John Woodward here on the left, nearest us, and Evan Mano.
A little motion from Woodward. Give us again to Mano. Oh, this time he's met in the backfield by two air defenders. Call it 2.5 air defenders. For a loss of probably 4 yards, maybe 3 yards on that play.
So going backwards here, not a good start on offense, but a big break for Littleton to get the ball right away, get the ball in the second half. Chance to, you know, try to take a lead here.
Yeah, they want to get at least a couple of first downs, if not score, obviously, but they don't want to be three and out. So they're getting the play again.
Gregory Shane's been really throwing the ball very well the last couple of weeks, so I'd like to see him go to the air here.
Nope, it's going to give to Maurice again. He's looking for his blockers to set something up. Not much going there at all. He maybe got back to the line of scrimmage. Might have picked up a yard.
Yeah, he got one or two there. It looks, you know, that very far side of the field. It's hard to see, but yeah, set him up for third and long here.
Well, looking at the flag, the wind is non-existent this morning, which is good. So should be able to throw the ball.
Yeah, I'd prefer they not have waited till third and long, but, you know, get half, go for it on fourth down is what I'm thinking here for Littleton.
You got Woodward down here in the bottom of the screen. Looks like DeShane's going to roll out.
There's going to be another flag.
Oh, he's got a good man down. Wide open.
That's number three, Justin Mano, but there is a hold. There's a penalty call on the backfield here, so it's going to come back. Nice scramble by number 13, Gregory DeShane. Got out of the pocket. We know why he got out of the pocket now. There was a hold on the offense. So
that's too bad because Mano, Matt had a nice route there. He had a little curl out, and then he took a right and went up the field, and his defender had about at least 5 yards.
Yeah, he lost track of him on that scramble. The defensive players kind of came up to meet the quarterback or start heading towards the quarterback. And it looks like it was going to be a run, and Gregory DeShane threw a beautiful pass down the sideline to Justin Mano, but again, wiped out here. It's going to be third and a mile.
Well, so far the offense has put up 11, 12, 15 yards, but it's unfortunately in the negative column. Again, here's DeShane. He steps back. He's going to throw out. Nice catch. He's going to get back.
Gross with the catch.
I mean, that's a...
Oh, Mark Fazoli, number five. I take that back.
It's a 14-yard gain, but it's now third and 10. Well, fourth and 10, rather.
That actually was number six, Brady DeCoste with the catch.
Oh, Littleton quickly lines up.
Oh, they jumped. They jumped. They're going to get half of it right
there. Okay, we'll take it.
makes fourth and five very manageable. Giant play right here for the beginning of the game. Littleton, you know, they want to keep that offense off the field and, you know, picking up this first down, keeping that clock ticking as they drive, make a drive here would be hugely important. So that time, Gregory Duchesne had time to throw and he was able to find his receiver. So give him a little time. He'll have an opportunity to hit that open player.
All right, single back. Duchesne again, quick out. Oh, it's almost intercepted. But that's that'll turn the ball over anyway. Probably smart play to not catch that because.
And that was number one, the quarterback, Brian Holmes, that almost intercepted the ball there.
Yeah. He's going to get an extra, you know, when they turn it over, he'll get an extra 6 yards from where he would have caught it and gone out of bounds. So all right, Ayer takes over now. We'll see. That was not a good opening drive series, to be honest with you, John.
No, not a good drive, but they, you know, despite two holding penalties, they were able to do some things. So certainly better than some of their games have been on their first drive, but, you know, obviously not the result they were looking for.
Give us up the middle, big hole.
It's number 20, James Gauntlet, with the run.
Yeah, he picks up 11 yards on that, moving the chains already.
Yeah, first and 10. They've moved over to Littleton's side of the field. You know, all eyes are on number 8, Caden Marshall, and they give the ball to the smaller running back, number 20, James Gauntlet there, who picked up a nice first down for Air Shirley.
Yeah, Gauntlet's just a junior.
So now they have the single back here, Marshall in the backfield. Let's see what all the hype's about.
Well, he gets the ball.
Nice tackle by the team there, Littleton. Now still Lorenzo in there on the tackle, among others.
That's interesting. Tall guy, he runs kind of straight up, you know.
Yeah, he's big.
But it gives you a lot of body to tackle if that's, you know, the way he runs. I'm not sure. I haven't seen him in play this year.
Good first response by the Littleton defense there with their stud running back.
All right, second and 8. And the shotgun, again, the handoff is just, and this time he bounces outside. Nice job. Picks, rambles for about 8 yards for another first down for Ayer. I tell you, the Ayer has to be happy about this field. They've struggled with the real grass field for years. And remember a couple years ago, they call it the Ice Bowl, where the field was just a solid sheet of ice because they plowed the field because it had snowed. And when they did, they just left enough on there to freeze.
Oh, boy.
It was terrible.
So the keeper by the
quarterback. Keeper.
That's Andrew Milner with the tackle.
Yeah,
66.
Pretty decent pursuit by Littleton. But a pickup, a big pickup, first down, 9 yards. Second and one on the 15.
Yeah, I'm surprised not every team in Massachusetts goes to, I know it's a big expense, but that cost you save on all the other things to go into the turf fields is very important. It's just a nice, you know, cushioned field to play on that gives everybody an opportunity to play on something that isn't going to be a sheet of ice, as you said, come late November.
All right, second one, and make that the 25-yard. Little pressure, but the quarterback's going to keep. He's got a lot of room. And he scrambles all the way inside the 10, which will set up a first and goal from the 9.
That tackle was made by, I think it was made by Zach Miller, Andrew Miller again.
Yeah, I'm curious to wonder if that was a designed play, because he didn't really put much time into looking for an open receiver.
Well, he had pressure on the right side there by Littleton's defense. Evan Montgomery got in there, so did number 10, Zach Milner, and looked like he just made that decision right away. Saw there was man defense, so he knew he had some space on that side if he was able to get out of the pocket.
All right, first and goal, single back, shotgun, snap is quarterback, delay, keep. Good pursuit by Littleton.
Number 3, Justin Mano, with he sort of drove him back into the defense with number 9, Alex DeLorenzo, and
He was
like 14, Nick Brooks in on the tackle.
Yeah, he was able to pick up a gain of 5 yards, so it'll be second and goal to go at the four.
Be an opportunity. I see a nice negative play for Littleton. Need to get them driven back a little bit here instead of giving them yardage. You know, they...
Air spreads it out. They got three receivers over the left. But they're going to just hand it up to the middle of the big guy. And he rambles in for the touchdown.
Cam Marshall, the senior. So right down the field.
Yeah, nothing fancy from Air. Just kind of in your face, up the gut, take it to him football.
Yeah, exactly what we expected from them today. And
you look at the size of their offensive line. They're, they got some big guys down there and certainly are moving, driving Littleton back, you know, 3-4 yards on the snap. Oh, high snap. It's going to be blocked.
He was already down there, so they tried to pick it up, but he was down. So,
well, that
no
was,
conversion.
That was a good play for this defense getting in there. And, of course, that all was triggered by a very high snap. It was a good job by the place kicker to grab it, but not enough time to get the rhythm. You know, everything about the extra point kicking game is a rhythm thing. You know, you practice.
I mean, that's why you see a lot of the high school teams go for two, because it's just not, you know, there's not a lot of a kicking game in the high school level.
Well, not everybody can have a TB12 like us.
Yeah, he was perfect on the season, but despite his missed, which was a block, so not technically something that he missed, but a good season for him in his first season as the kicker. And, you know, I did not mention he got the special teams award. Given out at the banquet the other night as well.
Nice. All right, Air will kick off. And back deep for is Maurice. But then there's a couple Tigers there, too. It's going to be midfield. Oh, nope. It's bobble. Oh, he's just going to hop on it.
The ball.
That was
Nick Brooks, number
Nick
14.
Brooks, the sophomore.
Yeah.
He probably could have picked that up and turn that into a little gain, but I'm not going to fault him for keeping the ball, right?
Nope, you gotta, you know.
I think
not
if he had
the ball over, so.
Yeah. Well, if he'd gotten on the cleanly on the first touch, I think so. But once he missed it, I think he thought there was going to be a little bit more pressure than really was. All right, first down for Littleton. They try to get Air to jump again.
And they look like they're showing a blitz up the middle here too. So Coach Easter will make an adjustment here to the call, maybe set up a little blocking scheme with the running backs help out.
Give his Maurice, he looks to nothing really, nothing here at all.
Yeah, no creativity on that play. They do the same thing every time, first time. Teams are ready for it. And they need to go to the air a few times on the first down play so they keep the other team from doing exactly what they did there, which is they stacked the line and they rushed, you know, they overwhelmed the offensive line with numbers and give Brian Reese no chance to make any yardage. Second and 11 here with four minutes and 18 seconds here in the first quarter left.
It's in as three receivers. It is going
to
be
a wide receiver screen to John Woodward. Nice job by John to break a tackle and gain about 6 yards.
Yeah. Be about second and seven. Or third and seven, sorry.
Yeah. All right, Littleton, you got to keep your defense off the field, which is most of the players anyway, but, you know, get a first down here.
Yeah, you got to get some momentum going here on the Littleton side, because we know that Air is not going to really have a problem scoring, it doesn't look like, unless Littleton can figure it out.
Well, rollout has number two, Evan Mano, there for a first down. A beautiful rollout by Gregory Duchesne. Hit number two, Evan Mano, on a little comeback route there on the right-hand side of the field.
Yeah, you know, Zach Milner was the up receiver on that route, and he put a hand up like it was overthrown to him. And good thing he didn't tip it, because
yeah, right behind him was Evan Mano waiting for the ball. Perfect throw by Gregory Duchesne, and a first down for Littleton.
Hey, well, this might be the key here, just to throw. Just keep throwing.
Yeah, you know.
If they can get time, if they can give Duchesne time to throw, I think that's probably the – you're not going to run on that front D, I don't think.
So now you got number six, Brady DeCoste in the backfield.
Oh, wow, DeCoste.
His first carry out of the backfield of the season for 9 yards.
That's good to see him in there in a different role, and healthy.
Even though he can throw the ball, he can move very well with the ball when he was running out of the pocket. And, Coach Easter using his ability to shake tackles and make some moves with some speed there for a nice gain.
Yeah, that's good. It's a good positive first down yardage. Brings up second and two.
Got Mark Fazoli in the backfield now.
Again, this gets the number five. That is Fazoli.
Fazoli,
and he gets another first down. That's great. Keep that ball rolling and the chains moving.
Nice couple of plays in a row there for Littleton. Moving closer to midfield.
Again, I got to say, I'm so impressed with Air and the job they've done this year. Their record, with the size of the team. I'm looking, usually playoff teams, they've got, 50 people on the roster, and I don't know, kudos to them. I mean, it's a good sign for Littleton, too,
Yeah, a team that normally struggles in football had a great season. We're happy for our neighbors. Not on today, though.
Right. Oh, the keep. That's interesting. Was that Maurice keeping?
Brian Maurice has been a lot of, lining up in the backfield last 3 weeks, and running that sort of wildcat offense where he's taking the ball and rushing running an option with number five, Mark Frizzoli. But we got Gregory Duchesne back in here for second and eight.
Yeah, Air has a lot of beef up the middle. I don't think you're going to get too much by going in the middle. I think you're going to keep it to the outsides, keep it to the off tackles, and throw. All right, second down and eight. And they are going to throw. Again, it's a quick
short.
So it looks like it bounced off the grass, off the turf, rather.
So looking for Justin Mano, number three, there on the throw. Pressure was coming in on the right side, and number 13 came in unblocked, and I think Gregory could feel that. Tried to get rid of it a little early, and so didn't get it out there far enough. Had the receiver, he was open, but just wasn't able to connect.
All right, third down and eight. Minute 29 left. As you can see, this quarter is flying. Oh, good. Next time was up the middle. Surprising, but positive gain there. Makes it. Oh, fourth and four, maybe?
Looks like they're going to punt here. Yeah, Littleton will punt the ball here, which...
Maybe.
Maybe.
We have not seen a fake punt yet.
Well, today would be the day to pull one out. Last day of the season. Nothing to lose.
Is that Brady DeCoste
that
punting?
That is Brady DeCoste
so
punting.
You never know. Oh, he will punt.
He will kick.
Nice roll. Yep. It's going to go down about the 20-yard line.
Nick Brooks, number 14, who started it on this end, will end it on that end with the downing of the ball at the 20-yard line.
Yeah, this quarter is flying by here, John.
Yeah.
I think everybody want the turkey.
Or the pie.
Or the pie, yes. That's right.
What is your favorite Thanksgiving part of the meal?
All of it. I love all of it, honestly.
You don't leave anything out, like the cranberry sauce or anything like that?
Nope. Put it all on the plate.
I love it. Me too. Even the vegetables.
That's right. Quarterback keeper. Cuts back the other way.
Moves by number one.
Couple of juke moves. Still on his feet. Finally tackled from behind.
The ball is down. Oh. Out. Littleton will get it back.
And it is Littleton ball. That's the second time I think he's fumbled, right?
That is the second time that he's fumbled, number one, Brian Holmes. And a big break because that was a huge run, about 35 yards for Air Shirley. So another turnover, and Littleton needs to capitalize here.
Wow, pretty decent field position for Littleton. Right at the 45-yard line, their own 45.
seconds left.
Nothing going right to work here. Not going to give them any chance to breathe.
Nope. Not take that back. They're doing the old jump off size, trying to get 5 yards any way they can. Give this to Maurice. This time he makes a nice cut.
It's cut by the MVP right there, Ryan.
Yeah, he shakes off a couple of tackles and picks up a nice, decent 7 yard gain on first down.
So even though I critique the team for making that play over and over again, it worked out there for a nice 7 yard gain.
Hey, well, I said they shouldn't run up the middle either. So
that's why we're up here. And that's right. Down there.
Again, same play, but this time it's nothing. So what are you going to do, you know? Yep. We're both right.
Third and three, and that's the end of the quarter.
Yeah, that is the end of the first quarter. 6-0, air on top, and Littleton with the ball. We'll switch sides. John, it's you know, a lot of things Littleton needs to improve on. We've only seen Ayers' offense take the field once, and they came down the field pretty easily and scored. So we'll see if Littleton can at least counteract with a touchdown here on this drive. Just keep it going.
Yeah, I mean, if the first quarter has told us anything, that the defense will be bending and, you know, giving up some yardage. Two turnovers, no points off the turnovers so far. Littleton has a chance to do that here on this drive, but they're going to have to score to stay in this game and give them an opportunity to win the way that Air Shirley is being able to run the ball.
Yep. Now, I don't know if you're watching this on delayed broadcast or if you're watching it, trying to watch it live, not sure. We're not on a hard line today. We're using a hotspot. Judy Reed, our camera person extraordinaire up there, she's set up her phone as a hotspot. So we're not sure how good the signal is. If it's cutting in and out, we apologize. We do the best we can with what we've got.
The very least, you can watch the recording, the rebroadcast, when you put it, get it back up on to
absolutely
the YouTube channel.
Yep. All right, so the second quarter underway. Littleton, Duchesne calling out the play there. Maurice the lone back, and third down. It's going to give it to him again. He spins.
Lost the yard.
Interesting third down call. I don't know. I don't see the punting unit coming on, so it looks like Littleton's just going to say, you know what? Let's just go for it. We need to score. You know, Littleton, obviously, Ayer's going to score. We need to score, so let's just do it.
They're trying to get them to jump here. Maybe they're not going to run a play here after all.
No, still are. Unless they decide to do one of those quick kicks. Taking a lot of time, though. You can see the ref back there. Well, they did get it off. It's a quick out, and it's caught. Oh, reaches out for the first down. Of course, he would have had it anyway, but he did, you know, reach out to
get
an extra couple yards.
Yeah, sometimes when you get on the field and you have the ball, especially with the R6 down the other end of the sideline, you're not sure where you are with that. So good heads-up play by Justin Mano to reach out if he was short, but he did have it already.
Oh, I'm glad they went for it on fourth down. That's good. And keep those chains moving. They take a long time to get a playoff, though. I like it when they speed up the pace a little
bit. You know, a lot of teams huddle and then they come out. So this is how they, you know, call their plays here in Littleton with that right at the line of scrimmage. It feels longer than it is. Back to Brian Maurice.
Wow.
Gaining 4, 5, 6 yards there.
Just kind of sneaking his way in. Finding a hole here and there. And a nice 5 yard pickup on first down. It's good to get to keep those positive yardage.
Yeah, got to keep moving towards that goal line.
Little screen out. Oh,
wheel pat, rat, pat.
Oh, well, no, it should. It was a forward pass. It was a forward pass.
And Brian Reese is upset. You can see him reaching for his helmet there because he knows if he did catch that ball, he had room to go. So just in and out of the hands there. You know, kind of a quick, hard throw there from a very short distance. Maybe looked like it caught Brian by a little bit of surprise there.
That brings up third and five. Again, I have to mention what a beautiful day it is here. Thanksgiving morning. Sun shining. Makes it feel a little warmer than it probably is. Oh, he heaves one up. He's got somebody, but...
Number three!
Oh, and he dives and there's touchdown!
Touchdown!
Wow. You know, we talked about Mano doing that dive move there. There it is.
Yeah, you know, Gregory Deschain had a little bit of pressure. He, you know, and once he sensed that pressure, he stepped back and just fired as far down the field as he could. As number three, Justin Mano, got behind the safeties.
That was about 47 yards in the air.
Yeah, and, you know, a little bit of a mistimed jump by the safety. We'll take it. You know, and Justin made a great catch and dived to the end zone to tie up the game.
Of course, now we have the sure-footed Tyler Branco. Now, are we going to jinx him by saying that? We'll find out. Good snap. It's down. It's up and good.
Littleton has the lead here in the second quarter, 7-6. A beautiful throw by Gregory Deschain and catch by Justin Mano. The line gave him just enough time to get there.
You know, and looking at different schedules, different teams playing different teams this year, I was just on the MIAA and the Max Press Preps website, just kind of, I just like to surf there for a while, you know?
Yeah.
And it's amazing how one team will dominate another team, but then when that team plays somebody else, they end up beating a team that team that just dominated them. You know, I mean, any week can be... up in the air. You never know. You know, Littleton just might have just the right personnel to give Air some trouble.
And that's the beauty of football, right? Like you can have a team that's not as big and not as fast, but if they execute their plays with some good coaching and you know, some breaks like they've gotten so far.
Yeah, Littleton's had two fumble recoveries.
Other team.
Yeah. All right, we'll see. What Branco decides to do here.
Yeah, I saw that scrub kick. It's probably trying to keep that ball away from their big.
Yeah, it does give it a little kick. It does field it cleanly.
A little charity hop there to.
Oh, nice move.
20.
Good James good tackle and pursuit by Littleton. Oh, there's going to be a flag.
Is there a face mask there at the end? I'm not sure. So got it back to about midfield.
We'll see what the white hat has to say here.
It is a face personal mask foul, on Littleton. Yep. Sometimes you gotta tackle him any way you can, even if it's a penalty. So, but that's gonna set up Air Shirley with a very good field position to start this drive.
Well, you'd say that if it was just one on one, but when there's three Littleton defenders there, you might say, let the other guys tackle rather than pick up an extra 15 yards.
Yeah. Sometimes your hand just finds your way to the face mask.
That's the other thing. You know, you're grabbing for stuff, and it's so quick.
It didn't look like a personal foul
to
me. No,
it didn't.
Like
you didn't even see
play,
it from up here.
I'm not sure if there is even just like a regular
a bullet to
That's number eight, Cam.
Oh, look at that.
Marshall, they're a big stud, so they're right back in the lead here. One play. Oh, they're going to call him down at the 1 yard line, 2 yard line. He stepped out.
That's interesting. That's very interesting because he didn't need to do that.
Nope, he had plenty of room, it looked like.
But it looks like he dove for the pylon, which he hit, obviously. Oh. That's interesting. I hope they fix that pylon.
Yeah, you'd think someone would go over and pick that up since it's a big part of the game.
The ref would have noticed he knocked the pylon over.
Up there he goes. So it's going to be first and goal from the 2 yard line here. You know, this is when those little breaks happen, right? They should have scored. They didn't. Now there's a mixed up snap, a fumble, a turnover, something that Littleton needs to happen here on first and goal. Quarterback keeper. He's going to go in for the touchdown very easily.
Quite easily.
Number one, Brian Holmes with the touchdown. He has the two fumbles, by the way, so making amends there for your Air Shirley to take the lead right back.
Well, to his defense, he's had a stellar season. He's probably the MVP of their team.
selection from the band.
Obviously, senior captain.
And Eric Shirley will go for two here after missing their previous kick. We're getting blocked. It's a big play for Littleton here to stop them. Keep that score differential less than seven.
Another quarterback keeper. He's going to drive in and he's in.
That's Holmes again for the keeper for the touch for the two-point conversion. So a short-lived lead, Mark. Short-lived lead, but a lead nonetheless was that had for about 35 seconds.
Yeah, it was. It was short-lived, but you know, it's better than a zero up there, that's for sure. So, and you know, Littleton can score too. They just showed they could. So,
yeah, they were able to move the ball there, and you know,
while we have a break here before the next kickoff here, we talk about the annual tradition in Littleton. Next weekend, December 3rd, is the Holiday Bazaar at the middle school. It's from 9 to 3, and it's always a great event. Of course, this year it's going to be a little mixed emotions because Millie McGovern, one of the persons who's been heading that up for years, passed away recently, and she's certainly going to be missed, not only there, but just in town in general. You know, she's a great lady.
Yeah, very sad day for Littleton when Millie passed. You know, always... gave me a smile to see her. You know, a couple other things happening. I can go over that with you as well next weekend. And the ball goes out of bounds, so Littleton will get good field position. Yeah, also Friday night, Littleton Park and Rec is going to be running a bowl-a-thon. It helps our Holiday Helpers program, which is gives, you know, Littleton gifts, gives gifts to families that are in need.
Yep.
So it's a fundraiser for us. That'll be at the Acton Bowlerdrome at 6 p.m.
Is that one of those neon things with the neon lights?
No, just a regular candle pin bowling night. Come down. The Gutter Gals won that last year. We came in second, but all right, they're going to redo the kick with a five-yard penalty. So, surprising. Traditionally, you see that team will get the ball out at the 40. So, I'm not sure what happened there.
I think they do have the option, right? That's a penalty they get to choose. So,
yep.
Littleton opted to have them kick again.
Yeah, so Friday night is the bowl-a-thon. Saturday is the bazaar. Sunday is the tree lighting ceremony here in Littleton. So a fun holiday weekend next weekend here.
This time it's going to be Woodward. Going to try to get his screens. Oh, no.
Thrown down by number 50.
Oh, yeah. Number 50. Nobody touched him. He just went in there and just... threw him down
Jack
like a
Jeanette
like is, a WWE.
Yeah, John should have probably cut that one back inside. He had a blocker. Not that he was going to really block that guy. He had a size differential, but he would have been able to get enough in his way where he was able to cut up the field. But
I always found it better to run away from the big people. I just thought that was always a good technique. All right, so don't know if this field position is any better than what they would have gotten, but... Uh-oh, the ball's on the ground.
Kirgan Shane picks it up, and he's going to be dropped for a 5-6 yard loss. So that read option, he looks like, you know, Gregory handed off the ball, Gregory Shane, to number one, Brian Maurice. And it didn't look like, it looked like he was trying to pull it back at the same time that Brian was reaching for it. And I think he kept it in there too long, and that's where the ball kind of got, you know.
Yeah, that was a big loss. Maybe 5 yards.
Yeah, that's what we talked about, execution, right? If you execute your plays, who knows what that would have done. It certainly wouldn't have been a, you know, 7 yard loss as we ended up there.
It's time
back to Brian Maurice.
He's going to cut it outside, try to use his speed. Stiff arms the guy, but no doing.
But a 1 yard gain. Third and long now.
Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 air defenders over there on the pursuit. Well, at least I like the fact Littleton's kind of mixing up their plays a little bit here. We got some passing, you got some throwing. It's not all just the same, which is good.
Just with the success of the pass, I'd like to see them throw the ball more on first down. I know they want to try to make things manageable, but I feel like the defense knows what's coming. Shane's back to pass.
Oh,
he's throwing a number. Oh,
he's open.
John Woodward. And it looks like that ball just got a little bit away from him. He had him open.
He
did. The ball was thrown about 5-10 yards out of bounds. So 4th and 14.
Yeah, put that in your memory bank, John, because you know Woodward obviously had a good 5 yard step on the two defenders for air. So
yeah.
Maybe nice go back to that. I'd like to see them go back to that.
Yeah, nice little up and out play where he was able to break free and get beyond the defense, but ball not delivered to where it needed to be.
Snap to Costa. Oh.
Almost blocked. Oh, it's hit number 5. Mark Frazzoli at the 45. So that's where the ball will be.
Yeah, it's about a 35-yard punt or so.
So Air Shirley will take over. So, yeah, so the Holiday Bowl is on for Littleton Park and Rec. We
great.
Got the bazaar.
It's a busy weekend, John. You know, you've got your bowl-a-thon Friday. You've got the Holiday Bazaar Saturday. You've got also Friday, Saturday, Sunday is the middle school play, which is at the high school, Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory. You want to come out and see that. And then there's tree lighting on Sunday in the Common, 4 o'clock or 4:30, somewhere in there.
I hear Santa's going to be there.
He will be.
From the 45.
Oh, it's number 20. There's a lot of room there. Oh!
Paul's what's wrong. Nice hit by number 14, Nick Brooks. Takes him out of bounds, but not before he got the first down in about a 20-yard gain. Littleton's D-line.
That wasn't very nice of him to gain 20 yards when I'm talking.
I know, we were talking about something, guys.
Yeah.
Give us a break. See a all lot right. of Littleton football alumni out there, too, wearing their jackets, so it's good to see them back visiting town for the holiday weekend.
Yeah, it is, and they've got nice bleachers now to sit on over here, so that's an incentive. All right, Air, 1st and 10 from their 38-yard line.
Back to pass, fake pumps right, left, goes right, and misses his receiver.
Well, he's got a strong arm.
Yeah, for a team that doesn't throw the ball very much, he looked in command in the pocket and nice delivery of the ball, even though he missed him high.
I mean, the last play where they almost scored the touchdown was a bullet, a short pass, but still it was like rifled in there. Well, that's good. 2nd and 10, no gain there on the pass, so maybe Air was just trying to keep them honest. I would assume they'd go back to their run game here.
2nd down, 10. Yeah, their line is certainly beating
the line
there.
Bounces out to the outside, lots of space. Oh,
a nice tackle from behind by number 9, Alex DeLorenzo. So probably a touchdown-saving tackle there. But, you know, he was 10, 12 yards down the field before a Littleton player was within 5 yards of him there.
Yeah, safety for Littleton when he came up and just saw him in the running back look like a deer in the headlights. Like, what do? I think he's supposed to tackle him.
Yeah, their offensive line play is excellent for Air Shirley. They're really dominating the line of scrimmage right now, and you know, they don't even need to throw the ball the way this is, the game's playing out.
1st and 10.
Oh, there's another down again. Oh, he got recovered.
Uh-oh. Careful.
Oh, they're gonna call that a personal foul.
Yep.
That is a very, very late call on a play that the guy blatantly dove after he fell on the ground. That is a dive. That's a FIFA World Cup play right there I've ever seen.
Maybe, but then again, if that had been Air doing that to Littleton,
we would have been calling it the other way. I'm not saying it wasn't definitely something that happened, but you know, we would have been calling them a dirty team, right? And that's what that's our job is to do, Mark.
Okay. Well, there might be Air viewers here. I'm just trying to be sensitive here.
So it's going to be a 15-yard personal foul on Littleton.
They are our neighbors, right? And it is Thanksgiving. We have to have that the holiday spirit and all that.
Yeah. Well, the quarterback, you know, a little acting there seemed to pay off because that was certainly, you know.
Well, Littleton has the gift of giving today because they've been giving up a lot of yards to Air. So.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah, so, and I did mention Santa. He will be taking pictures with your child and anybody you'd like on at the Holiday Bazaar for a
And he sets outside in the little brick fireplace they got going on there. It's not a real fire. But
they're going to be back inside this year.
Oh, they are? Okay. Yeah. Well, I heard Saturday was supposed to be nice. So,
good nice. Weather. Oh, here's a reverse. Reverse. This is the nice play.
Snuffed out.
So that's the old Philly special that you saw run against the Patriots in Super Bowl 52, where they did the reverse and the quarterback went out for a pass, which was covered. So number eight, Cam Marshall, couldn't throw the ball. So a nice contained play by number 10, Zach Miller, with the tackle for a loss. So third and seven.
Well, this would be nice if, obviously we're in four down territory, but a couple stops here and give Littleton some life. There's another play up the middle.
And that offensive line, see how that offensive line is driving Littleton 5-10 yards off the ball. They're just really dominating that line of scrimmage. It's hard to overcome that with a line play. They have some really big boys there.
I see Thomas having a little struggle out there on that play.
Yeah, he was definitely getting dominated by the lineman who was blocking him. I hate to admit, but he's trying to draw the flag at the end. Did you see that? Where he flopped.
Yeah.
Kind of trying to reverse that little move that quarterback Brian Holmes pulled on Littleton just a few plays ago.
It's good to see that you taught him some things.
Yep. There's the flop. I'm the king of the flop.
Nice hit, but it's in for a touchdown again for air.
Touchdown.
They go up 20-7.
Yeah, and that was, I'm not sure who ran that in. Was that the quarterback keeper? Or number 22 there. Wyatt Gallant, looks like maybe. I'm not sure who had that touchdown, but it is a two-score game now.
20-7, Dan.
They will go for two again.
They'll line up for the two-point conversion.
So quarterback keeper again. Oh, Zach Miller with a great tackle to get him. Oh, he was definitely down. It looked like he did flip back over on his feet, pop right back up. But a nice play by the mid-watch all-star number 10, Zach Miller, to stop the conversion.
Yeah, Zach's had a great year. I think he probably leads the team in tackles.
Definitely.
Am I right?
Yeah. There's no doubt that he leads the team in tackles. He's had a great season on both sides of the ball, especially on the defensive side of the ball. Again, both Milner boys will be back next year. So,
yeah, that's good. Zach's only a sophomore.
And Andrew's a junior. Yep. Yeah, so it'd be good to have both those guys back. They lose a lot of seniors this year, so it'd be very interesting to see what happens to Littleton football next year with 13 seniors turning over and graduating.
Well, I think they should shut down all other sports and then make all the boys go off of football.
Yes, I agree.
Oh, it's just a suggestion. I don't know. That will fly.
Well, unfortunately, Littleton football is sort of fading out here a little bit. The Littleton Youth Football Organization folded up shop this year, unfortunately. We did have a flag football program, but there was also another program known as the Knights. It was a group of surrounding towns that had a tackle youth league. So there are some players still playing, but again, not as many as they used to be.
Yeah. This time Woodward gets by that big guy. Does get tossed out of bounds.
Tackled by number 99, Kevin Surrett, another senior for Air Shirley.
Taken down on the coverage by Kevin Surrett, number 99 for the band.
So it will be first and 10 from the 34-yard line for Littleton. Love to see the merit out here. Love to see the merit out.
Yeah. About a 15-yard return. So Littleton will start first and 10 on the 34-yard line. They do pass. Oh, nice
catch by Brady DeCoste. He's going to break free. He's going
to hold on to that ball, Brady.
Well, good job by switching it to the outside hand. Gets down to the 2-yard line.
Wow.
That was a great read option by Gregory Duchesne. He had, that same play that they've been trying to, they set them up for.
Wow.
Right there. Hit number 6, Brady DeCoste on the slant. Great catch. Broke the tackle. and was free. So now they need to punch it in here if they're inside the 3-yard line.
That was a great call because, again, it looked like they were just going to go back to that vanilla play of run up the middle. Pitches to
pass to number one, Brian Reese.
Oh, he's trying to get it.
It through the end zone. That's going to be a touchback. They're going to call that a touchback. So it will go over to Air Shirley.
Oh,
as an unfortunate break. So Brian Reese fumbled the ball. He was trying to reach out to get to the pylon. Ball goes through the end zone and out of bounds. That ends up being a touchback for the opponent. And they will take over at the 20.
That's heartbreaking.
That is a very tough break. Well, that's that's the breaks that we're hoping for to happen on the other side of the ball when they're down at our goal line. That those big hustle plays where you come from behind 20 yards downfield and you make a tackle right before the end zone.
Yeah.
And you think, oh, it's going to be an automatic that they're going to get in the end zone. Those are the kind of things that happen where you make that hustle play.
Yeah, what we could use is another air turnover down this side of the field. That would be nice. All right, air takes over on the 20-yard line. They got 80 yards to go. It's 3:53 in the half. This time they're going to looking to throw. Yep.
Number 10, Zach Milner again gets back there right away. Incomplete. Both Milner boys were right there.
Yeah, good pursuit by Littleton, good coverage by the defense.
Yeah, the quarterback wanted a personal foul, late hit, as Zach Milner looks like he hit him just as he got rid of the ball and threw him out of bounds. So their quarterback was wanting a call and didn't get it.
Maybe someday he can go to ref school and he can make those calls. Right now, he's just a player.
All right, second and 10 here from the 20. Handoff number 22.
Oh, nice job by Frizzoli.
Pulled down by number 5, Mark Frizzoli, for a loss. And that was the runner that had the touchdown.
Yeah, they tried
20, Jeanette.
Tried to bounce it out, and all of a sudden didn't see Frizzoli there because his lineman probably blocked the view. Frizzoli just snuck out, made a nice tackle for no
James
gain.
James Gauntlet. I just called him Jeanette, but it is Gauntlet.
All right, third and 10. This would be a big play here. John, if they could. This is not 4-down territory.
Yeah, big play here for Littleton. They had a chance to score to get it a 1-score game, and they need to respond on the defensive side of the ball. Back to throw over the middle. It's way over up top as both the receivers collided there. I don't know if you saw that, number 8 and number 13. So 4th and 10. Littleton is going to hold here. Let's see if they punt.
Oh, I don't know.
So the referee just pushed the Littleton player, number 55.
Yeah.
Not what you like to see a referee put their hands on a player, but looked like Evan was arguing with their team about something, not sure what.
I don't think I've ever seen that before.
So Air Shirley will punt.
Uh-oh, Littleton's got to get...
Too many men on the field here. A timeout was called by Littleton before they were able to get the punt off. So a little confusion as they were able to get their players on and off the field there for the punt team.
What has just transpired in this last couple minutes? It's some weird stuff going on out here.
Yeah, it's getting a little chippy out there for sure. I think both teams are the close rivalry, the last game emotions are high, and a couple drawn penalties on the personal fouls. So I don't love to see a referee put their hands on a player, but I'm not sure exactly what influenced that.
We also have a 50-50 raffle sponsored by the class of 2026.
So the Powder Puff game was Tuesday night. Seniors versus juniors. And
the seniors
won. I was
able
to referee the game with Brent DeBraga, one of our other Park and Rec, and Chris Maurice. Chris Mason and I and Brent DeBreger officiated. Seniors did win 41-28. So,
wow. Yeah, that's an interesting question. Jenna Kivlin plays on the varsity football team. Did she play in the Powder Puff?
She did.
Too?
She did. She rolled. You know, I just talked to her this morning. She was still. She's still upset with me for calling her personal foul after she turned and railroaded one of the girls and ran her over on her way for a game. And she only got two personal fouls as the puck goes here and rolls to the Littleton 34.5-yard line. But another fun tradition here at Littleton High School, where the Powder Puff, the varsity players, coach up the girls.
Yeah.
At Alumni Field, which was Tuesday night.
Now back in my day, when they had the Powder Puffs, the football players would do the cheerleading. Do they do that anymore?
No, really, they do not do that anymore. They have them coaching and assisting on the sidelines. Otherwise, maybe that's a little not PC anymore, I would imagine.
I guess. Fun. I guess fun is not PC
no
anymore.
No more fun anymore. Can't have fun anymore. I agree.
Well, let's hope Littleton has a little fun right here. They got 2 minutes and 46 seconds to put some points on the board, and then, of course, they get the ball to start the second half. So let's see if they can put on a long drive. They're looking to throw. He's hit as he throw. Oh, that's going to be. Oh!
Did he come up with it? He's juggling it. So that's juggled, very underthrown ball to number three, Justin Mano, and Littleton turns the ball right back over. So, yes, I did want him to air it out. I did not want them to, try to throw
a little
ball
bit too much air, a little too much air on that one.
Yeah, just
when you mean, when you say air it out, you mean in this atmosphere, right? That ice on it when it came down.
And Judy upstairs was feeling the wind, mentioned that the wind did pick up and it is blowing in that direction where it held that ball up and was intercepting. So definitely a factor on that throw.
Well, that would be unfortunate if air turns this around into another big point. Oh, running back runs right into
Nice tackle by Alex DeLorenzo, number 9. Number 66.
Interesting. He had a lot of room to the left and right and chose to go straight. And it got stopped. But we'll take it. All right. Second and 5 for air. The 6-3 Panthers have looked good so far. They've had a few turnovers, though, that have cost them. Littleton has not really taken advantage of those.
Again, number 8.
But this time he stopped short of the first down.
Yeah, number 10, Zach Miller. Number 59, Thomas Kazanjian. And number 66, Andrew Miller with the tackle. So second short.
See a little bit of sportsmanship out there as people helping each other up from opposing teams. I like to do that, you know. You hit the guy, you drive him to the ground, then you help him up. That's good. That's good sportsmanship. Third and 1. Again, up the middle is just.
But Littleton's defense is playing a lot better on the line of scrimmage right now, so that's a promising. Even though they got the first down, they're not getting driven off the ball like they were in the first 2 or 3 drives.
Well, Littleton.
It's going to be a timeout here by Air.
Yeah, with 1:16 left. Air definitely wants to punch in another score here.
Yeah, obviously a huge drive. Before they threw that interception, I was mentioned to you that Littleton had an opportunity to go down and score before the end of the half and then get the ball in the second half. That would have been the ideal situation with a chance to kind of either tie the game or take the lead. Instead, they're hoping to make a stop and keep them off the board here before the half. So,
John, before the game, I was walking around, and I was over by the snack shack. They weren't open yet. But anyway, I saw a couple ladies selling bracelets for the Air High School Marching Band, and they were trying to raise money to go to Rock and Roll Hall of Fame in Cleveland, where they'll actually be performing. So,
wow, very cool.
I told her, and one of the ladies says, my husband is Zach Hurdle. So it's Zach Hurdle's wife over there who must work for the AIR school system, and she's involved with the band and doing her part here on Thanksgiving. Zach Kertle, of course, the voice of the Tigers in the booth.
Good pursuit by Littleton defense there. What a move by number one. And a tackle by number 61. That's Delade McCoy with the tackle. Oh, Joey Taylor with the sack. Great tackle. Great pursuit by Littleton's defense on that.
So it'll be second, clock is still running here.
Should
so.
Be running, yeah. Should be running. Not a throw. Second down, and the clock is Littleton's friend right now here. Try to prevent Air Shirley from getting in the end zone before the half. Back to pass again. Number one's got lots of time. He's trying to send him deep. Cuts back, and it is going to be complete to number eight. That's their stud, Cam Marshall, the senior, and it's going to be a timeout by Air Shirley. 22 seconds left here.
I tell you, if I think, I'm not sure, but if Holmes is not a pitcher in baseball, he's got a career there. That thing was probably 70 miles an hour, that little
ball. Yeah, that ball is on a, you can hang your clothes on it.
Anyway, I was mentioned about the Air marching band, and, you know, when I was talking to the ladies, I said, they wanted me to buy a bracelet. I didn't have any money. So I said, but I'll tell you what I'll do. We'll record the band at halftime. So we're going to show the band at halftime and their routine. And normally we would take a break then, but I'm going to make Judy work during halftime because, you know, I can do that.
And then pitch their bracelets for sale.
And pitch the bracelets, yeah.
Have you ever been to the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame?
I have not.
I've been, I have been, and my trip was to go to a football game in Cincinnati. So we started out, you know, in Northern Ohio, and then in Cleveland, and went to the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, and then the Football Hall of Fame, which was going to be, to me, was the highlight of the trip. But the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame was much better.
Wow.
I couldn't believe I would say that because I'm a big football guy, but it is an unbelievable facility.
Nice. Well, I wish the band luck. Hope they get there. And all right, first down. Quarterback is going to throw a bomb.
It's a nice throw out there. Looks like he's going to cut incomplete. He's out of bounds.
Too bad.
He's trying to sell his case over there, Cam Marshall, again. Yeah. Heck of a throw and catch, but not just a little bit out of bounds. I know that's the far end. It's hard for us to see, but the referees made the call right away that he was out of bounds.
So that took 8 seconds off the clock. So they probably have enough time if they throw it for maybe two more plays.
Yeah, and they're out of timeouts as well. So any tackle that's inbounds on you know, that doesn't go out of bounds is going to run that clock out here for the half for sure. So Littleton hanging tough. They're doing, you know, they're playing with everything they got. You can see that out there, and they're doing okay. They're holding their own against this team that, you know, a lot of people thought was just going to walk over Littleton. So hardly this three-man rush by Littleton. Throw is up. So a tackle is important here. So the clock will stop while they move the chains.
We still have a timeout.
Oh, okay. The scoreboard said no timeouts left. But there was actually one timeout left for Air Shirley. The referee in the booth is apologizing to me profusely for making a mistake for not showing that timeout. We're going to forgive you, sir. It is Thanksgiving.
Yes.
It is a time of forgiveness.
All right. So the Air does take a timeout. And
got you.
That was a nice throw by Holmes on that. Again, showing off his arm.
So this will be the last play. I didn't realize they had one timeout left. And it will be a
This is big. First and 10, yes, but they've only got an extra 3 yards to go for a touchdown. So,
and it has to be a touchdown or the half will run out here.
Yep. So Littleton just needs to stop one play and go into the locker room and regroup.
So they're going to go trips left here, which, and a receiver to the right. So they're thinning out the middle here. I think they're going to try to pound it right up the middle. Nope, they're going to go to the Air, and it's a fade pattern and caught, but it looks like he's out of bounds. And he is out of bounds, and that will end the half.
Wow. Nice throw too, but All for naught. So good job by Littleton defense and keeping them out of the end zone. So, all right. So what we're going to do, we're going to stay here because we're going to show the marching band and the halftime festivities. I can talk. And we'll be back with third quarter action after that.
I'll be back as well.
All right. Thanks. Stay with us.
Thank you, Mr. Southwick, for helping out. Ben, happy Thanksgiving to you. Well, the Panthers are leaving the field. They're going to the locker room for halftime, and they set up the field. I'd like to do an announcement here for the band. The Air Shirley Marching Band 2022 season, their halftime show is called Defining a Champion, featuring the music of the Beatles, Queen, and Lady Gaga. Directed by Mr. Powderly, show designed by Adam Stark, Jamie Fortier, and Mike Linehan. Drum majors Malia Marina, Teddy McDonald, marching band seniors Ava Sheriff, Maggie Serator, Malia Marina, Angela Mavilia, and Jameson Carroll. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your Air Shirley marching band for 2022. Give them a hand. Again, your Air Shirley Regional Marching Band. We'll be right back.
was conducted by drum major Teddy McDonald, and on the flag, Abby Alberta. Drum major Malia Marinez conducting.
Okay. applause, folks. The Air Shirley Regional High School Marching Band, 2022 season, as they won their gold medal at competition. Thank you very much.
All right, welcome back to the third quarter here. Air kicks off. Fresh 12 minutes.
Short kick picked up by Zach Milner.
Rambles up. Nice pickup there, almost close to midfield. He's around 45-yard line, maybe.
The flag, it looks like, has been thrown. Would you like to see that? Yeah, it looks like there's going to be another flag here. Late hit or taunting of some sort. Looks like it was a personal foul at the end of the play. Dead ball. Personal foul against Air Shirley. So it's a nice break.
Yeah.
For Littleton. I didn't see exactly what happened, Mark. Did you there?
Just a lot of activity over there in the sidelines, you know. And I think the Air's coming out pumped up. Littleton's coming out pumped up. It's Turkey Day. And emotions are going to run both sides, I think, for the rest of the game. Can't help that. All right. I do want to mention, though, John, that halftime, that the Air Shirley marching band doing a great job out there.
Yeah, that was really
playing
cool.
The 80s tunes, which I enjoyed.
Yeah. Yeah, that was fun. They were, you know, I don't know if you noticed, but one of their band players is blind. They had a lead, a person walking him
I did notice that.
Around. I wasn't sure. Oh, boy. So that lead option play hit Brian Maurice for a loss. Looks like number 60, 70. I'm not sure. Who got that? Maybe 50.
Number 50.
50 Jack Jeanette on the sack. That's the loss, tackle for a loss. Another senior for for Air Charlie.
Yeah. If Maurice had nine lives, I think he might have lost one of them on that
Yeah,
one.
He got crushed.
Yeah, that brought him back 4 yards, so it would be second and 14. Just on the 44. Swing out to
wide receiver.
Nothing doing. Uh-oh. A little bit of taunting there going on. I don't know. I guess they allow that.
Yeah, it didn't look like he was doing anything derogatory right at the player. He was celebrating with his team more than anything. But
sometimes when you're walking over somebody and you yell and stuff, yeah. It just seems like it's taunting. Anyway, it was a good play. So I guess I'd be taunting too. Another loss of four. They're going backwards here, John. Start the second half, so.
Ball's back at the 48-yard line.
Air is coming up, firing on all cylinders here. Another pass.
Oh, 13's in alone there. Good throw by 13, Gregory Duchesne, to number 7, Teddy Hunt, first catch of the day.
If they give him forward progress, which they do, they get back to about the line of scrimmage, close to it.
Yeah, 4th and 11, Littleton will go for it for sure. Yeah, the Air Shirley defender came untouched in on the right-hand side of the line, and Gregory Duchesne stepped into his throw. Great throw to Teddy Hunt. Make it 4th and at least a little bit more manageable than it was.
Nope, they're going to decide to punt.
Punt.
Interesting.
So trapped, they trying to kept Air Shirley's regular defensive alignment on the field.
Uh-oh.
Oh, a terrible punt. Oh, hit coach. Hit one of the little coaches on the fly, but that was about a 7-yard punt. Certainly not what Littleton wanted to happen there. So, very bad break.
Yeah, that's a. It's about as ugly as a punt as you're going to see right there.
Yeah, you know, he had a lot of pressure, so he had to get rid of it probably a little quicker than he wanted to. And, you know, that's pace and rhythm. When you get thrown off as a kicker, throws you, you know, if one little thing goes wrong, and it's hard to get off that good solid punt like you'd like.
All right. So Air takes over now here in the third quarter of Thanksgiving football. Give us a keep to the quarterback, the option play. He's got
a stiff arm by number 1, the quarterback.
Oh.
The tackle by number 5, Mark Fazoli. But a nice stiff arm by the quarterback, Brian Holmes. On, it looked like it was on.
It was more like a slap down than a stiff arm. He just kind of tackled him with one arm.
That will give it a first down at 46-yard line.
Air Shirley seems to have the energy here in the second half.
Yeah, they certainly have started off on the foot they wanted to in the second half. They'll give you another quarterback keeper on the read option. Another first down, or almost first down here. And a late flag again, two late flags. This game is getting a little out of hand for the referees here. A lot of personal foul, late foul, late whistles, late flags on these plays. It's another personal foul. It's going to be on Littleton.
Personal foul against Littleton.
Not sure what it was.
I told you that I could tell that things are going to get chippy here. Crosstown rivals, one team had a very successful year, the other one not so much so, and frustration.
One team so far this half, after a few in the first half. Ooh, number 61, Joey Taylor missed the tackle, but number 5, Mark Fazoli with the tackle after a 5-yard gain. That was number 20, Gauntlet again with the run.
Yeah, you know it's tough when you're looking at a 7-yard gain as a success.
Yeah, again, Littleton's holding their own. I mean, they're not getting blown out of the building. I know it can end up that way, but they're playing okay. You know they're out there with a lot of effort and heart to try to, you know, finish the season on the right foot.
Quarterback option. Keep.
Another flag. A late flag on the backfield. Looks like maybe a hold or a block in the back on the Air Shirley lineman, number 58.
Holding to be against the Panthers.
It's not my car, is it, Judy? Okay. All right, yeah. I hear the heard a car horn going on off in the parking lot.
I don't have a good enough car to have an alarm on it, though. So I'm hoping people take it, you know?
Yeah. I've seen your monster.
I know. I love that car. Yeah. I'm like, you know, just teasing. It's got that beautiful Jeep. I do love it.
All right, second and 12. Again, this time they hand off number 8. It's kind of grabbed
nice
by...
Nice job by number 10, Zach Milner.
Yeah, Milner.
He looked like he had the edge. Zach grabbed a hold of his jersey, pulled himself closer to it, and made the tackle. Very excellent play there, which looked like it could have been a big gain on the right side. It's going to be 3rd and 15 here, and 3rd and 5. Big play again for Littleton's defense. I would imagine that Eric Shirley would go for it. I was talking to one of the fans here in between the half and mentioned that their long snapper struggles, so cost them a few games.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so I don't imagine that you'll see a lot of that in this game here. Maybe always going for the conversion. And they're going to pick up the first down easily here with number 8. Number 5, Mark Frizzoli got a piece of him, a shoestring tackle.
You see Cam Marshall, he's pretty big for a running back.
Yeah, you're right. He does run straight up and down, but it works for him.
Like a gazelle.
It's going to be first and goal here from the 10.
They don't list the height and weight on the air roster, which is too bad because I'd like to know what some of these guys are.
Yeah, I mean, that they're
number right 56
tackle
over there. Yeah,
he's a big guy.
He takes up 2 spots on the plane.
Back to number 8. With a nice tackle there by number 55, Evan Montgomery with the tackle. Nice tackle for little to no gain.
Second goal. You know, we've done some games over the years on Thanksgiving where the weather has been terrible. Just awful to be out in it.
Do you want a sandwich or a cinnamon roll?
Not today.
Yeah, I'm very happy to see that the it's a beautiful day today, especially for Judy upstairs.
That's right. You know, thank her for coming out and sacrificing, putting the turkey in early for the game.
Oh, nice tackle by on the Patrick back. Ferrara, the senior, with a heck of a tackle on the backfield on the quarterback keeper. Littleton's showing a lot of grit and toughness on this drive here, kind of, you know, backed up against the wall here with a chance for this game to get out of hand, and they're holding tight here.
Man, it would be great. It'd be great to have stop of. You know, it's tough. Air has got the weapons, and not just one.
So 3rd and 10 here for Air Shirley. 3rd goal. I would imagine they would go for it again as they have some struggles with the kicking game.
Yeah, and I would also imagine they'd keep it to the game, to the ground, because they just got the weapons, you know. At this time in there or not.
3rd and goal from the 10.
Lone back.
Oh, he's going to throw. That's number 10, Zach Milner. Oh. Pursue with a great sack. The heck of a job by number 10, Zachary Milner, with the sack. He's having a great season. He's capping it off here with an excellent day here on the defensive side of the ball. Be 3rd and 15, so 4th and 15.
Thanks. Wow. Well, this would be nice stop here for Littleton. 4th down, we'll see what happens. They're backed up now to the 15-yard line.
Yeah, this is a gigantic play in the game here for Littleton.
This time
back
gonna
to pass here. Yep. He's got some time. Look, there's a hold on the defense.
Oh,
number 66, Zach Andrew Milner with the pick.
Wow.
What a great play by Andrew Milner over the middle of the field. I see no flags. It'll be Littleton's ball.
Yeah. Good stand by Littleton.
Defensive stand. Excellent defensive stand.
Again, a bullet, but it's just Milner doing a great job stepping in there.
He even surprised himself when he looked down and he had the ball. He was like, he thought he dropped it. He juggled it and came up with it. So,
well, it's not often you see someone with a six number that starts with a six doing something like that.
Yeah. Yeah, and Andrew Milner and Zach Milner having a great game here today for Littleton.
Right, Littleton takes over now. A long way to go here in this, on the field and in the game. Good.
Maurice. Play to Brian Maurice. Oh, look at that. Hard for
yeah,
first
keeping
down.
His legs going, pumping, driving for getting out of the shadow of the end zone and moving out all the way out to the 32-yard line.
28.
All the way out to the 28-yard line.
Counting the wrong way off that.
I was.
Hopeful. That was wishful thinking. So 3.5 left to go. Littleton's ball. You know, very. Not sure what the announcement was there. Was that? Did you hear that? Oh, that probably put it, Brian Reese over 1,000 yards rushing.
That's Frizzoli.
Nice little gain
yeah,
again.
Yeah, it picks up caught about the edge. 4 yards on that play. Listen, yeah. Anytime you can go positive,
yeah, and
we'll take
Frizzoli
it.
Has had, you know, he hadn't played running back for the first 7 games of the season. Last 3 games, he stepped in and played a very good role. Hard running, tough yards when they needed him most, and he's done an excellent job stepping into the backfield. And they got the wildcat sort of look with Brian Maurice taking the snaps.
You see they got DeCoste down here, the wide receiver position. Nice to see another one maybe go to him.
Once again, DeMarc Frizzoli is going to take a loss here. Again, tough running, as you see there. He will not go down easily.
It took the entire line. Whoop, Judy.
Well, are you okay up there?
Yeah, you're right.
We thought we lost Judy there for a moment, everybody, but that was not her fault. It was the camera. Getting out of their hands, but nope, there's not a gust of wind out there, Judy, but trying to blame the wind upstairs, yeah. But not happening today.
I just hope she's strapped in. I don't want her to fall. Cameras can be replaced. Judy cannot be replaced.
So 3rd and 6, you still got Brian Maurice under center, so it's going to be a run here. Oh, is he going to throw the ball?
No, it looks like he's going to get tackled for a loss. That's
not loving this play call here. At all, you know, you're not giving your team a chance to throw the ball when you have your thrower on the sideline.
Yeah, don't have much of a choice here either to probably just to punt, being this deep.
Well, it looks like they will punt. I see Brady Coast is going back there to take the snap. Need a better kick this time for sure.
Yeah, but other than 5 yards, that would be good. We'll go for 6 this time?
No, let's see a 30, 40-yard punt. See this roll. Good bounce.
It stays in bounds, too, so.
All the way down to the nice try by number 21. That was Connor McNeil. That's something that, no surprise seeing him do that.
See, like what? It just took a good bounce, an extra bounce at the end.
I see Cody Shearer, our former kicker down here. Mr. Menachem down there as well.
Oh, I'm sure these guys are looking. You know, this is the thing about high school football. You know, you can play basketball, pick up leagues. You can play baseball and softball and all these things when you graduate. But you never get a chance really to play football unless you play the college level, and not many people do.
Oh, nice job by number 3, Justin Mano, to shed that blocker and come back and make a tackle, because his back was turned to the play and made a turn. You know, faced forward, saw the running back coming right at him and took him down. Nice play, but 5-yard gain by Air Shirley.
Yeah. Ran about 25 yards to gain 5.
It's going to be the last play of the quarter there.
That was a quick quarter. All right, well, no change in the score from halftime. Both teams had the ball. Both teams drove a little bit. And both teams stalled a little bit.
Both teams took personal fouls.
Mm-hmm.
But the, you know, this is the last quarter of a lot of careers here for Littleton football.
Yeah, that's what, kind of what I was saying. You know, you don't get to put on pads and stuff. You may pick up games and flag football and stuff, but never like this. And so,
yeah, and you know, emotions, you know, people are, it's going to come flooding in for these players. It's going to be the last time that they suit them up, and this is it. So I would imagine you'll see some emotions high at the end of this game, some sadness, some relief the season's over, and some, you know, don't start, you know, a lot of lasts of the Judy asked me how I'm gonna do, but
yeah,
you know,
it is tough as a parent, isn't it, when you,
yeah,
I mean, it's funny that you call him your baby boy, even though he's one of the biggest guys in the field, but that's what they are, you know, they're always our kids. And
yep.
They wished, too, that they'd had a little bit better of a season. It's nice that they picked up a couple wins towards the end. And there's still another quarter of football here, so we'll see what happens. But Air starts off the fourth quarter, second and five. Give us up the middle. Oh, bounces out to the nothing there.
Nice move by
turns it into a nice game.
And that's going to be a, looks like, we got him by the jersey, number 10, Zach Miller, not after he got the first down. Thought maybe they're going to call a horse collar there. He grabbed him down from, but he wasn't grabbing the pads. He grabbed the shirt to grab him around, the jersey to get him down. Littleton's cheerleaders doing some acrobatics over here to our right. This is their last, a lot of their last, so they have four seniors as well on that that cheer roster this year.
Yeah. They're like professional dance troupe, those ladies. They do a great job in their halftime routine. It's time it's the quarterback's going to keep. Oh,
lowers his shoulder. Nice tough running by number one, Brian Holmes. So it'd be nice to mention some of the seniors over here. We got Hannah Honchell. We got Shayla. Her last name escapes me. And
let's just go with first names then.
And Courtney Hood. I know she's another senior as well. So Emma Zidovich, is that how you say her name? I'm not sure, but I think that is our last senior for the cheer squad. So, you know, it's a big day for everybody, you know, the seniors. It's the last, you know, as I've been saying all year already, it's a lot of lasts for everybody. This is the last time to do this, last time to do that.
Cam Marshall, the ball carry.
So that was tackled. Actually, Jack Cormier is out on the field, a youngster there. He's a freshman with the tackle, one of the bigger freshmen on the team. So he's getting some play time here on the line. A nice job there making the tackle.
Judy, just check the connection on your in and out. It says no signal. Just make sure it's in tight.
Back. A lot of technical difficulties today here, but we're doing okay. We're going to get through this as well. And that's number 8, Cam Marshall with another big game. Tackled by number 3, Justin Mano.
Yep, looks like they're going to be first down. Oh, it's... really?
All right, it's going to be first down.
Okay, thanks.
At the 26-yard line.
Seems to be steady. We'll see. Sorry, talking to Judy through the headset.
No,
sometimes
they
get on the air. Our camera's going to color bars here, so they have to switch to camera 2. And
so the Littleton offense asking Littleton defense to once again make another stop. You know, if Littleton gets the ball back here with an opportunity, they need to change up what they're doing on offense. And that's number 59, the baby boy, Thomas Kazanjian. They're going to call a penalty on what? I'm not sure why. I guess he tackled them too rough, and there's another flag. Not sure what he did wrong there, but got to tackle the player the way you can tackle the player.
Well, also, yeah, Joey Taylor and some other, one of the air players kind of
that's going to be pushing. On air. So personal foul on Air Shirley. The coaches want some clarification. Speaking of coaches, Coach Easter lost his grandparents, both grandparents, within a few days this last week. And, you know, we want to send our condolences to his family today.
Oh, wow. That's tough.
Yeah. And so we wanted to mention that, and our hearts go out to Coach Easter and his family today.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I know that he comes from, I think, Brooklyn, New York is where he's from, and that's, I'd imagine that's where his grandparents are from. And, not sure about that, but yes, our condolences to him for sure.
Referees are making some clarification on maybe the spot of the foul or the down.
Well, that's kind of a little bit of a break here for Littleton. Not a little bit, but a big break.
Yeah, second and 22, it looks like. Second and 20. Yeah. But the scoreboard has first down. Looked like it happened at the end of the play, so it should be second down. Which the yard marker shows as well. So I think that's what they're trying to get clarification on here, if it's first down or second down. Referees making their way over to the Littleton sideline to explain the situation to Coach Easter. We will take this opportunity to thank all the coaches for all their many hours of work.
Yeah, go for it.
Coach Asante Easter in his rookie year with Littleton. Coach Justin Leonard, Bobby Hebert, who's on top there with Judy there, helping on the headset. Tim O'Neill and Kelton Brackett. They had their first year in Littleton, so it was very, you know, we want to thank them as a parent of Littleton, as well as a Littleton resident, of all their hours and hours of dedication, the practices, the film work, the meetings. You know, that starts all the way back in the end of July and you know, that's a long time to coach. It's longer than most of the seasons take, as all the other seasons have stopped already, you know, a week or two ago, and football continues through Thanksgiving.
Yeah, it's a long season, as Mike Lynn can attest. 17 years he did that job, and he said he's so relieved to have his weekends and his nights and things. He still does his AD duties, but just to be free like that, it's a big commitment.
So they're at 20 on the run, and that's a nice tackle by Thomas Kazanjian.
Wow.
Heck of a tackle by the baby boy. This is makes you proud on his last game in the last quarter to make a nice tackle like that. I'm sure he'll be talking about that at the Thanksgiving dinner table today.
If he does it, I'm sure you will.
So that will bring up third and 25 or 26 here.
Third and 31 from the Tiger 39.
Clock is ticking down here, so.
Littleton defense showing a lot of heart.
I don't know if they're talking to you or the other guy.
I don't know who they're talking to. They're getting some waves up here. You know, we're celebrities, Mark.
Well, I know.
People want to be near us and see how we're doing.
That reminds me where timeout on the field. All the fan mail we've been getting, John, you want me to hold on to that or forward it to you, or what do you want me to do?
Yeah, you know, we'll come in. I'll come in 1 week and we'll just sit down and read through them.
Okay. I think it's fan mail. It could be hate mail. I don't know. We'll have to see once I have to open them. I see if I'm looking out in the distance here, there's a guy running around the baseball field. This is like doing a bunch of laps around the complex. And I'm thinking I could think of 100 other things to do on Thanksgiving than go jogging.
I guess you can run off those calories before you eat. I'm looking forward to the food coma that takes place around an hour after the turkey's been digested, and you loosen the belt, and you're watching NFL games.
It's obscene. It really
nothing
is.
Better. Thanksgiving is by far and away my favorite holiday. You know, there's no expectation. You don't have to bring anything. You don't have to do anything. You have to prepare,
yeah,
except for the meal. And you just have family to get together time, and that's all it's about. And that's, you know, and the food, of course, it's right. All the best.
Yeah, they have some sort of turkey trot here in air too, I think, on Thanksgiving. So maybe that guy up there got off the path. All right, air's going to go, throw it. And,
oh, no.
It dropped.
There was number 22.
Oh, he had it.
Wyatt Gallant there, who had a touchdown earlier. And that was a gigantic drop because that would have picked up the first down, and it's going to be fourth and long.
You know, I just want to point out, John, that we're only down two scores. You know.
Looks like they're going to punt. Which, from what I understand, the long snapper struggles. So this could be a very big opportunity for Littleton to get some sort of break, some sort of turnover. That was a good snap by the long snapper. So.
Oh, let it go. Let it go.
Get it in the end
zone. Go, 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 go.
Knocked it in the end zone. That was a big break by Littleton again. Yeah. Doesn't matter that you touched it. You just tell the referee, I touched it over here, but
right.
You have to stop the ball from going in the end zone. So that is going to be a touchback for Littleton. The referees are talking about it. I'm not sure why. Yes, it is a touchback, so they will bring it out to the 20.
7:44 left in this fourth quarter here. And like I said, two touchdowns and crazier things have happened, you know?
Yeah, so now that Littleton, they can't just be conservative here. They got to attack the edges, attack the defensive. Like, don't air it out. Don't try to throw the one touchdown, the one play. When the Littleton throws the ball, those little outs, those little slant patterns, that's when they're the most successful throwing the ball.
Uh-oh.
And they jumped off sides.
Yeah, they did. Littleton did.
Oh, did Littleton? Yeah, it looked like it was against the defense. They're going to call it against the offense.
Yeah.
Again, not a good start on the offensive side of the ball. The defensive side has been, you know, really stepped up today. Played an excellent game to right this moment. Offensive side has been struggling.
But they have had some big plays where they've got big chunks of yards, so we'll see.
And he hits number three, Justin Mano, for about 6 yards. A little throw to the right. That's what I'm talking about. Those little dinks and danks really work. Give your opportunities to your some really good athletes on the edges. John Woodward, number 11, number two, Justin Mano, Evan Mano, number three, Justin Mano, Teddy Hunt. Those guys can make plays, and when you give them a chance downfield, they have a better chance of trying to run through the line of scrimmage. That's Brian Maurice for a run up the middle for about three. Not bad.
Second down, he picks up about 4 yards, maybe five.
Third and manageable here for Littleton.
Yeah, third and four, I'd call it.
And a five, be third down to four. More. The 25.
Gregory Deshane in the backfield's had a good finish to the season. He's got to hit John Woodward. They're a little short on the throw.
Oh, too bad.
Didn't step into that throw. He kind of was flat-footed if you saw him there. Get rid of the ball. And you can see it because it didn't quite get to him as quickly as it should have. And that's a bad break because he was open and he had a first down there. So,
I mean, really don't have much of a choice here. I mean, they're probably going to make him try to jump off sides, right?
Yeah, I'm sure that's the first move, and then they'll go for it.
Oh, wow.
Shane's scrambling. He's going to throw it up for nobody there. Looks like he's trying to hit Brian Maurice on a broken play, and it'll be Air Shirley's ball. That was, you know, that's that rollout play. And if the edge isn't sealed, he's got nowhere to go to turn upfield to hit the receiver coming out. So that play was broken up by good coverage, you know, good rush on the left side of the ball by Air Shirley.
The only thing I can think of is that nothing to lose type of deal. You know, like they don't think they're going to score two touchdowns in 6 minutes, so might as well just try to get one, you know?
Yeah, that just was a play that was doomed from the start, unfortunately.
Cam Marshall, the ball carrier.
It's a nice tackle by number 14.
All right,
Nick
stop,
Brooks.
stop now.
Nick Brooks is another good-looking underclassman, a sophomore who's had, was really good. JV had some great plays on both sides of the ball, made some plays on the varsity level as well. He'll be a guy to look out for next year for your 2023 Tigers.
He's the one that had the big stick earlier in the game. Knocked the guy out of the sidelines.
Yeah, he's a good young player.
All right, second and short. Give up the middle.
Yeah, Marshall, the ball carrier.
Number 9, looked like Alex DeLorenzo with the tackle.
Marshall picks up the first down. And it will be just outside the 10, so it's still first and 10 now at the 13-yard line.
Yeah, Mayor Shirley, they're giving it to their big running back here to run this game out. Smart decision by Air Shirley to use your best player, who's big. It's got to take a lot of guys to take him down, and this defense is worn down. They made a lot of tackles, a lot of plays on the defensive side of the ball.
Quarterback keeper.
Nice play. I think that was Mark Frazzoli.
Oh, the ball's
another
out.
Fumble. Another fumble. And wow. It is Littleton's ball. Another break. A huge break here with 5:10 left.
I think that's his third.
Yeah, that's three fumbles by number one Brian Holmes in his last game as a senior. Certainly something I'm sure he's not going to want to remember. I guess the win or the loss is most important. But, single-handedly keeping Littleton in the game with those fumbles.
Well, this is the best season Ayers had in a long time. 6 wins, playoffs. Good things for their program. All right, Littleton takes over with a long way to go. First down. Give us to Maurice.
First and 10. Maurice, the ball carrier.
Nice run by Brian Maurice to start this drive. Not a lot of time left, though. They got to start getting the ball down the field.
Number 66 on the gap. Along with Brian Holmes, number 1.
Nope. That's the thing. Clock is not their friend now.
Nope. Clock is the enemy. They need to get down, score, and get an onside kick or quick turnover to try to make this into a win. But love to see them get it into a one-score game here.
Yeah, I don't think you should be making them. Look at how much time is wasted when you're trying to get them to jump off time sides here, Out to
number 2, Evan
first down.
Well, Mano.
He gets
10 yards and a first down there.
I don't know if he got out of bounds, though.
No, the clock will stop until they reset the sticks. He didn't get out of bounds, and then once that's set, now they'll wind the clock here again.
Referee still warning people to just, chill out.
It is a Littleton Tiger first down. With 4:05 left, fourth quarter.
High snap to number 1, Brian. He's trying to catch that edge. And he does. Gets about 4 or 5 yards.
Carrying the ball.
No, nice tackle by number 51. That's Gabe DaCosta. Another senior there with a nice tackle. Second down. Littleton is not. They're in a rush, but they're not. They need to, the pace needs to be a little bit stronger, but, they are moving the ball here.
Haven't targeted Woodward much this game.
And he's got a pile behind number 6, Brady DeCoste there. Kind of threw it to in between 2 players that neither one of them were there. So, incompletion. Does stop the clock, so it gives them a minute to sort of reset and call the right play here on 3rd and 5, 3rd and 6.
See that gentle breeze blowing over there now. It's at the the back
a
of
flag down here before the play was off. Another false start by Littleton. Make it 3rd and 11.
I was saying the wind is at the back of DeShane, so at least he's got that going for him. If there is any breeze. Yep.
3:25 left. That will stop the clock again on the penalty.
3rd and 10.
Third and 10.
Coach East is making the call on the sideline. Got trips right here. Gregory DeShea goes back to throw. He's going to John Woodward. He's got him. And he makes a heck of a catch down the sideline. He's trying to get into the end zone here. We need him to score here. And that's a big, gigantic touchdown. That's a 70-yard play. 75-yard touchdown pass from Gregory DeShea. You just said that. Nostradamus again, Mark Rory.
It's crazy. It's uncanny.
Says he hasn't thrown the ball to John Woodward. And just then, throws the ball up. John Woodward made a heck of a play. This is the kind of moments as a senior you're going to remember forever. Making that catch on Thanksgiving Day, scoring. It's going to be a one-score game here.
They don't have to go for two, which obviously they're not. They look like they're going to kick. They just need 2 7-pointers.
Yeah, Littleton's got a chance here. They, you know, that's the play they needed.
Now, I think they go for an onside kick if they get this. Snap is down. It's good. And a kick is. Oh, no.
No, he made it.
Wow.
He made it.
Oh.
That's a big extra point.
Oh, that's huge.
20 to 14. Air Shirley here with 3:14 left. Littleton's fired up on the sideline over there. They're getting together. They're going to make a play call here. What they're going to do. I think they will go for the onside kick. Got to give them their best chance to win here the way that.
Contrary to that, I see the air. They look pretty dejected right now. This could be that swing, the momentum swing we were looking for.
And this is what we were hoping for Littleton. That play with heart and desire and effort in that last game of the year, last game of your career as a senior. And they're doing just that today. No matter how this ends up here, they came in today with a team that was far superior to them with the record and how they played against other like opponents, and they're holding their own. So very proud of this team right now, the way that they're showing up and finishing out the season. Looks to me, the way he teed that up, he's going to kick an onside kick.
Hey, isn't this the way life is too? You know, you face obstacles, you face things, and you go through them. You plow through them.
Amen.
Yeah.
I see Coach telling him to pop it up way back there because there's only one guy back. But Marshall, their number eight, the big player, is going to run out of space there.
And he's going to go down. And falls.
So, all right, Littleton's going to stop them. Going to be deep in their end. The defense has to play. This is their time to shine here. This is their moment. And the sun to come up with a big, huge, another turnover would be nice.
Is that accurate? 2 timeouts left for Littleton?
Yes, I believe they called one earlier. I'm not sure.
Well, I tell you, we've been in many games with Littleton this year where the clock doesn't stop in the second half because they've been down so much. So they've come a long way in the last few weeks. And today is no exception.
Yeah, this is right where they wanted to be with an opportunity to win the game late. They gotta go to their running back number 8. Oh, he just broke a nice tackle there. Littleton's pulling at the ball. Second down, it looks like, and 1. Clock will run. Air Shirley will take their time, I'm sure. Not what you wanted. You probably wanted to see them get the first down there because now they get another play, right? They get the first down, and then it's like another opportunity for them to run the clock down. Littleton holding on to those timeouts. See what happens on this play. I imagine if they stop them here, you know, for a loss, they will take the timeout. I think they'll take the timeout either way, but.
Well, can we have 4 turnovers? That would be good.
And he's going to pick up the first down there. A little time. We'll call the timeout. No, it's a first down.
First and 10 at the 32.
No timeout by Littleton yet.
Timeout taken by Littleton.
No timeout.
No timeout, sorry. I heard a whistle, so. And I saw the clock stop.
All right, minute 55 here. Clock is ticking. Air Shirley's taking their time. with having Frizzoli come off the... looks like maybe, you know, number five, Mark Frizzoli's coming off the field. Maybe has he's bleeding or something. I'm not sure why he's getting walked off the field, but sometimes it's because they have like an open cut, usually is the case, but he's not getting tended to over there, so I'm sure he'll be right back out there. And Zach Milner, the nice, oh, almost dropped him for a loss. I'm sure Littleton will take a timeout here. They will. Coach Easton is running over, calling a timeout, so it'll be second and five. They had a chance to drop them for a loss there. Zach Milner got in the backfield, but a nice shedding of the tackle by the big running back, number eight, Ken Marshall.
Yeah, 1:32 left. I mean, you'd like to have a little bit more time on the clock. I think Littleton might look back on this game if it comes down to this is the final score, that they wasted a lot of time.
Yeah, I mean, they sometimes you critique it. Yeah, they're going too fast, they're going too slow. But when you're making the right calls and the right plays and they work out and you score, it's kind of what they're working towards. You know, they probably don't run that hurry-up offense very often. So...
well, so far they've won the half, right? I mean, it was 20-7 at half, and Littleton's the only team to score this half, so got to be happy about that.
Yeah, you know, again, playing with a lot of heart, a lot of effort. This is something to be proud of, like I said, regardless of how this thing ends up. And one more first down for Air Shirley, this game's over, so they have to stop him.
The Air Shirley 35.
Yeah. This is where you give it all. Oh,
Zach Milner with a great tackle again.
Wow.
Number 10, Zachary Milner with a tackle for a loss and another timeout by Littleton there. It looks like that's their final timeout.
A minute 25 left.
It might be. I don't remember them taking a timeout earlier in the half. But it is showing zero timeouts up there. Yeah, okay. I don't remember that, so. I think they have one more timeout left. We're not sure up here in the booth, but we'll find out after this play, because that is a gigantic tackle by Zach Milner for the loss.
Now, this is interesting, because if they happen to stop them here, they still got fourth down.
Well, I would imagine they would punt, given the time left. I think that they wouldn't want to give them the ball.
There's not enough time to milk the clock out to the end of the game, right?
Not unless they get a first down. So a stop here by Littleton. I think they're seeing their edges blitz. So they're going to give them an opportunity to make a throw here. And Littleton's doing a good job of making them have to make that kind of decision. Oh, no, he's got a big hole. And he's going to get the first down, and that will do it.
Stays in bounds, too.
And number eight there, running back Cam Marshall, who's had a great season for them, will have run the clock out for Air Shirley and give them the victory today. But again, a heck of an effort by Littleton.
Just have to take a couple knees here, right?
Yeah, they're going to take two knee downs and it'll be over. Anything can happen, though. You saw that Buffalo-Minnesota game a couple weeks ago where they stopped him at the goal line. And, the Buffalo was getting ready to take a knee to end the game, and they fumbled it in the end zone. But Minnesota picked it up and ended up winning that game.
Yeah, so that was crazy.
Still good to execute here.
They do look like they're a little bit in a victory formation here. The linesman has his hand up. Means 10 seconds. Takes a knee.
And that will do it there with the play clock. And the players are shaking hands at midfield. Littleton called timeout right there. They did have one timeout remaining, so they will take it there. Hey, you never know what's going to happen. You would hope that Littleton would try to at least defend a little bit. They're all kind of standing there. But
well, I think you're probably just not happy with the loss, obviously, but happy they didn't get blown out.
Yeah.
20-14 is respectable, you know, at least.
Very respectable game. Very good effort by this team. They came together at the end of the season and really did a great job after really struggling. And the Littleton fans are applauding their team over here, the parents I see over here to our right, giving them a much deserved applause for their efforts in this game. And that is the ball game. So, Mark?
Yes, John.
That, was a
that is the ball
season.
Game.
I appreciate you inviting me up here to the booth.
No problem. As the final seconds tick off, we want to wish all our viewers a happy Thanksgiving, a happy holiday season, whatever that means for you. And John, thank you so much for stepping in and doing the games this year. Maybe we'll continue this tradition.
Yeah,
for
I'd
the
love
next...
to. I really enjoyed it. I had a great time. You know, gonna see what baby boy number two is doing next year before I can commit. But you know,
sure.
Very thrilled to be here. Thank you for having me. I enjoyed every minute of it, and you know, it was fun to be part of my son's senior season. So thank you.
All right, 20-14, the final here. Air over Littleton on Thanksgiving Day 2022. I'm Mark Crory along with John Kazanjian. Have a great Thanksgiving, everybody.
Happy
and thanks,
Thanksgiving.
Judy Reed.
Thank you, Judy.
Yep.